Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So can you believe we're already in the second last month of the year? Like, I'm finding it really hard to comprehend that. I try not to start every monthly favorites with talking about how much time has passed, but now that we're already in November, I think it warrants a mention for sure. I just want to take a minute to ask you guys to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. We're really close to 9,000 subscribers, and I would appreciate if you hit that subscribe button. Only if you enjoy my content, it would make me very, very happy. I know I make these monthly favorites videos pretty random, but I think for my October favorites, I want to focus on slightly like autumn, winter related beauty stuff that I've loved. I also have a blog post up on my blog which talks about everything else that's happened in the month, whether it's some notes on my travel, some music recommendations and stuff like that. But this month's favorites is going to be a little bit more beauty oriented with one sort of fashion slash tech item at the end. So the best thing about like the last part of October is that it's gotten a lot cooler. Now I know Mumbai doesn't have much of a serious winter and we don't get to wear boots or heavy jackets or anything, but it still gets a little colder. And for me, the first sign of cooler weather is that my skin starts getting drier. So I think it's very, very necessary to focus more on like hydration and nourishment and moisturization during this month. You should be moisturizing all throughout the year, but it's just even more important during this time to keep your skin like nice and healthy and happy. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is the Forest Essentials Mashobra Honey and Vanilla Bath and Shower Oil. I think they have this bath and shower oil in like 5 different variants. I was just most drawn to the Mashobra Honey and Vanilla fragrance because vanilla is like one of my favorites. So you have that little spice of vanilla with a little hint of sweetness of the honey, and it's not super cloying. I do not like very sugary sweet smells, but this one balances out really nicely. Basically, there are a few different ways you can use this oil. You can put it into your like bathtub if you're having a bath. You can even put it into your bucket, like if you're having a bucket bath. I love bucket baths. The most common way to use this is during the shower after you cleanse your body. So after you've like soaped or whatever and washed that off, you just take a little bit of this in your palms and apply it like wherever you really need that moisturization. And what that does is it just helps to lock in a little bit of that moisture, because I really like hot water baths too. I know that they are not like healthy for your skin, and they're even worse in the winter, because when I have a hot bath in the winter, it's comforting during that time, but when I step out of the bathroom, my skin is so dry. So this just adds a little bit of hydration to your body, and because it's an oil, your skin doesn't get like super dry again really quickly. It's quite similar to the Nuxe Huile Prodigious in the sense that it's not really greasy or not really oily, and it absorbs into the skin really well. Couple of times I even found myself reaching for it like after I've stepped out of the bathroom and everything, just to give myself this little boost of moisture. Before I'm photographing an outfit post, I love to put oil on my hands and legs. Not only does it like leave your skin hydrated and it doesn't give you that dry white cast in photos, but oil just adds a little bit of sheen. So I've really been loving this. Not the cheapest product, but you know, even if you use it daily, it hardly goes down. So I would totally recommend picking this up if it sounds like something you'd be into. The next product, also a skincare item, is something that I got last year. I reviewed on my blog last year, but it's one of those things that I ended up rediscovering again. The Body Shop Oils of Life Intensely Revitalizing Sleeping Cream. This has a few different precious oils in it, and sleeping cream just means night cream. Since I do like my main face skincare routine at night, I've been reaching for this cream a lot. If you have any dry patches or anything on your face and you're feeling like your regular moisturizer is not giving them enough of hydration in this season, this one does a really good job. Don't let the oils of life name fool you. It's not oily, sort of like a gel texture, and it still hydrates really nicely. I think it's also good for all skin types. My mom and me have very different skin types, and we can both use this cream, and there is a full review on my blog. It does have kind of a strong smell. It's not bad at all. It's similar to the Oils of Life oil, which I reviewed like I think about 2 years ago on this YouTube channel. So yeah, it's pretty nice. Next, I have another basic product from Kama Ayurveda that I just rediscovered again in my stash and I've been enjoying using. So I finished off my regular La Roche-Posay toner. I've used like a few bottles up of those, and instead of immediately purchasing a new one, again I said, let me see what I have at home already and let me finish it off. So I ended up finding the Kama Ayurveda pure rose water. This is steam distilled, and I already have had this a while and I use it as a face mist. It smells really nice and it's really refreshing, especially during summer. I knew you could use it as a toner, I just never really tried it. But for the last month or more than a month, I have been using this. It's just one ingredient, it's just rose water. There is like nothing else in it, but it does a really good job of toning your skin. It closes up the pores nicely, it removes any dirt residue, soap residue on your face, and then you can move on with your skincare routine. So I don't think toners have to be really complicated to work well, or they don't have to have a lot of ingredients. I just like my toner to be sort of gentle, cleansing, soothing, and it's not stripping. This checks all the boxes for me. It's something natural and suited to all skin types. It's something again that me and my mom can share, even though we have different skin types. So I've been loving it. I have the big bottle and this one is well worn. That shows you how much I love it. And I also have this small one, which you can carry with you in your bag or whatever. I totally understand why people are so obsessed with this product, because you can get rose water easily in India. But if you're putting it in your face, I would say better to get like the best quality one out there. And that would be the Kama Ayurveda one, in my opinion at least. Now we're moving on to makeup, and in last month's favorite video I mentioned that I started using foundation again after a really long time. Like for a year I didn't use liquid foundation, I was just using powders, but I felt like using foundation again. And for almost 2 months then, I've been using the Nykaa Skin Genius foundation. They sent these over, and at first when I read about the foundation, I thought it would not work well for me, because they have sort of written about it as something that's better for normal to dry skin types, and I have oily skin. But as we move into the colder months, my skin settles and it becomes more dry, less oily, like it just sort of becomes a combination. They build this as a sculpting and hydrating foundation, and they also say that it has some technology that it sort of adapts to your skin color. It's like a nice cream texture. When I first put it on my face, I find that it does look a little pale, but I usually have to wait like 5 to 10 minutes and it settles into something that matches my skin color really well. The formulation obviously is definitely not matte, not too dewy also. They say it's a very skin-like finish, so it's satiny. If you have very oily skin, I would recommend powdering on top. I am wearing it with some powder on top, of course. But I think this is really, really nice foundation. Since I had all 5 shades, I mixed 2 to get my perfect shade. Number 3, Warm Sand, and number 4, True Tan. So I'll use more of True Tan, but I'll lighten it slightly with Warm Sand. If I were to repurchase only one of these, I would say number 4 True Tan is fine for my skin color. Little bit on the slightly darker side, but it adjusts well. It gives me a good medium coverage. I have blemishes and like slight dark spots on the side of my cheek, and it does a good job of almost hiding them. Then I'll usually put a little concealer on top. So I like that the bottles are really a small, light, plastic, and super travel friendly. I will not wear this when my skin is really greasy, like when we go into summer, but I think in winter I will get a lot of use from these. And if you have normal to dry skin type, I would really, really recommend checking these out. I am pretty damn impressed. You guys know I love my lipsticks, and after a while I have one lipstick recommendation. This is a luxury product. It's the Guerlain? I think it's Guerlain. New Kiss Kiss Matte Lipstick. So Guerlain is a luxury French makeup brand, and they used to be there in India, but they weren't there for a while, and they recently relaunched in a big way. They brought out some new skincare as well as this new range of lipsticks. One of the things that I love about Guerlain is they have one of the fanciest packagings ever, because I think that if you're going to be splurging on luxury makeup, like when I bought a Chanel nail polish, I'm also buying it because it looks so good as an object, not just how it functions. So I have been obsessed with this lipstick, like mainly just the packaging of it, because look at it, it's so cool. It's like a muted matte gold brick. Looks so great on your dresser. But coming to the actual lipstick, the shade that I have is Zesty Orange, and you guys know I love my orange lipsticks. I generally gravitate more towards orange in the summertime, but I think that because we live in a tropical country, it's pretty hot all the year round and I can wear it anytime. I'm wearing it on my lips right now. And I just think that orange lipsticks go so well with most Indian skin tones because we have warm undertones. So if you're light or dark skin, just that orange brings out the warmth in your face and it's just a very flattering color. So this is supposed to be one of those non-drying mattes. In fact, they say it has mango butter and stuff, so it's actually supposed to be nourishing. I think it's really quite a creamy matte. And it settles down to a more matte texture. The pigmentation of this is totally buildable. I feel like you can do one or two swipes for a more like wash type of color, or you can do a few more swipes to get full pigmentation, which is what I prefer to wear it as. I know a lot of people like to wear lipsticks sort of as stains also. They have a nice range of shades, right from the light to the dark and vampy ones. And I have been really liking this. I am going to have a detailed blog post review on this lipstick within the next few days that will address it in a lot more detail. If you have any questions about it, let me know in the comments below and I will sort of incorporate that in the blog post. I have one nail polish that I've worn throughout October. I think I removed and reapplied it at least 3 or 4 times. It's the LYN Nails nail polish from their new vegan collection in the shade Genie in a Bottle. I've just worn it for most of the month. I like that it's vegan because there are very few brands in India that have proper vegan polishes. The reason that I picked this one this month is because it's kind of a unique shade. It's sort of a green, blue, deep teal. It just goes with a lot of things. It has a nice shine. And you can probably wear it for longer if you put a top coat on top, but I generally skip top coats because I'm lazy. I just am quite in love with the shade and I've been wearing it continuously. So we're done with all of my beauty favorites. The final item for this month is my phone case. I've been so obsessed with this. It's from this brand called Casetify. So they do a lot of really cute iPhone cases. I think they also have cases for Samsung Galaxy range and all, but it's mainly just iPhones, like all the models of iPhones. They also have Apple Watch bands and stuff, but I think they're most known for their cases. So they came out with this really cool glitter case line. It is personalized, so it is my name, Magali, printed on it. You can choose whatever glitter shade you want. I went with monochrome silver because the back of this case is also kind of transparent and my phone is silver. But they have like pink and they have like this holographic rainbow color. Some really, really cute options. I think a lot of us had pencil boxes or rulers when we were kids with this kind of liquid floating glitter inside. And this totally takes me back to being a kid. But I also think it looks really sophisticated and stylish. And it's totally a conversation starter. This is my first Casetify case. I had not tried the brand before, but I'm really quite impressed with it. I think the orders come in from Hong Kong. So since this was a custom order also, they shipped it out within 1 or 2 days. They had this printed and ready and I got it within 2 weeks, I think. So that was pretty impressive. I didn't have to pay any customs and oh yeah, shipping is also free internationally. This has proved to be really durable. I handle my phone pretty roughly. And the name has not worn out in any way. If you would like to order from them, I put a link in the description where you can get 15% off your first case order. Those were all of my favorites for the month of October. I've also started doing monthly mixtapes on SoundCloud, so I'll leave a link to that below. It's just 20 to 30 minutes of really chilled out music. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. I'm again re-plugging that I have a blog post out, and I would love if you would hop onto my blog and check out my October recap. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.